Today I'm going to be going over several spring loaded designs that I have printed. You can learn a lot just by looking at the designs online, but to actually have the physical print right in front of you really helps you learn and figure out flaws in designs as well as things that you can copy and use in your own designs. This is one of the first spring mechanisms I printed. This one is by Gesamwalt. I'm not really sure how to pronounce his name, but he makes some really awesome creations. This is one of his best ones in my opinion. This is called the Spring Demonstrator V2. So obviously it's the second version of his Spring Demonstrator. It uses a winding knob. This goes all the way through as an axle. Then we have this spiral torsion spring, which goes into a ratchet gear, which has a ratchet in it. And then we have two gears. These are the same gears right here. And that just transfers the force so that we get a nice spin. So here's when we wind it up. Boom. So you can see this one doesn't last very long. It's a pretty short-lived movement. But I did learn a lot from this one alone. And this one's just really, really cool. So here's another one. This is by the same guy. This uses a pallet, so you can see it kind of stops it. This is sort of a mix between his creation and my creation. I basically just made the bottom plate and I made the pallet. I wanted to basically look at that spring demonstrator that he had, and I wanted to see if I could make it have this pallet movement. So this was like the second thing that I printed. Here's how it works. So you can see this one's pretty junky, it skips a lot, and I wasn't really too happy with the pallet movement. There's also not really, you can see there's not very good tolerances or spacing between these pieces, so it does tend to jam up a little bit. Alright, this one right here is one of my favorites. This one is by Rob Ives, and you can get it at robives.com. I learned a lot from this one, especially the pallet movement is one of my favorites. I think it works really well. Here we go, I'll just crank it up for you guys. So you can see this one has quite a lot of motion due to the huge spring. But the key factor here is the pallet. Without the pallet, this motion would be 10 times faster. So I'll show you guys how it moves without the pallet. So let's take that off. Wind her up. And boom. So if you don't have the pallet, it's just gonna spin out of control. It basically uses the entire force of the spring. Whereas if we have this pallet on this gear right here, it's able to slow the movement down. You know, you can use these spiral torsion springs, but they just carry way too much force, as you just saw. So with the pallet, we can slow these movements down and make something more practical. Next up, I made this prototype. This is Clacker version 1. I did not release this one, but it was a good proof of concept, and it's what led to the next design. So it's like the spring motor V2 combined with Rob Ives' pallet technology. So I was able to make it more compact, and it's I tried to make it more of a stable device. So then this is the clockwork mechanism that I dropped just last week. I came up with a really thin frame design. So this is basically all there is to it, is just these two bottom and top plates. That's the frame. Wind her up. Doesn't last very long, but it's a cool proof of concept. Another thing is you can hold the knob and the whole thing will spin. Kind of cool. And you can get this one on myfangs.com. So this one I didn't print all the way, and I didn't completely finish the build, but it is really, really cool, and I would like to see this one fleshed out a little bit more. So when we crank this up, you'll see that gives a lot of force to this gear, which is only able to move when this red pallet moves out of the way. So we get a nice ticking movement. This could be used as a clock. If I got this weight right, the weight on this piece is just not correct, but the way it's supposed to move is going back and forth, and it's supposed to be able to keep that movement going. I would like to mess around with this one a little bit more, but definitely one to check out. So this one right here was released on Maker World not too long ago, and I'm actually very impressed by it because it's fully 3D printed and we're able to get a pretty decent movement from this one, better than most others, you know. And this is the closest thing to a clock mechanism I've seen yet. I was able to get this to go for like 17 seconds, but as you can see, it's a little bit finicky. Once it's wound up, this acts as a balance spring, so this will go back and forth like that. That's the idea. This one is wound up, so this gear just wants to go right the entire time. And then when this goes back and forth, this allows the pallet to bounce back and forth. And it's just a really nice, simple mechanism here. Catch the movement. There we go. Here's a different one that I never posted to my socials, but this one is really, really cool. It's just kind of hard to get on camera because the gears are hidden under this. But this is a spring boat model. So when you spin this, it's able to give an output to that shaft. And the way it's doing that is using a bevel gear right there, as you can see. So this one's really interesting in its own because the input force goes downwards, but the output force goes horizontal. So it's a little bit unique. And here's the mini version. I couldn't get this one to work, but this is the original size of the motorboat, which is pretty impressive. But I could not get this one to spin personally. And last but not least, we have the Tourbillons. So these things are really, really awesome. These are used in actual clockwork designs, and they are a very impressive feat of engineering. So here's how it works. You wind up this bottom gear, which has three ratchets on each corner. So we wind her up like this. It's already wound up actually. And then go like that. You can see this one has a pallet that allows this gear to rotate all the way around. People online have said that from this design, they've gotten it like a minute of time, which I'm pretty impressed by. I couldn't get more than a few seconds personally, but I still love the design and I'd like to reprint this one to see if I can get more time out of it. So you can see that middle spring is basically the balance spring, which the idea is that this is supposed to go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, and then the gear goes all the way around. Thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Peace out.